Hello, luxury real estate agents. Today, I want to demonstrate a little bit more about pricing benchmarks and how we can calculate them and how the spreadsheets that come with my book calculate them automatically. But don't forget, when you're doing a CMA, when you're presenting a price opinion to sellers, they love data. They don't always like what the data means, but they like to have data. The more information you give them about the marketplace, the more compelling your argument's going to be for the right price of their property. Buyers love data that supports their position of trying to get a lower price for the property. And one piece of data I noticed that people, the buyers really like in my marketplace is they like to compare the property tax assessment to the offering price. And they rarely like to pay more for a property than the tax authority has assessed it for. So sometimes when a property I have listed is priced way above the property tax assessment, I have to demonstrate that is typical in the marketplace for properties to sell for more than the assessment. And I'll show you how we do that in a second. My favorite benchmark we could use is the assessment ratio. You could also use price per acre, price per square foot, price per front foot, or even price per living square foot of the dwelling itself. But let's go back and spend more time on my favorite. The assessment ratio is calculated by taking the sales price, dividing by the assessment, and you get the assessment ratio. So if the house sold for $1,000,001, it was assessed for $1,000,000. Now you have an assessment ratio of 110%. If it sold for $900,000 and it was assessed for $1,000,000, now the ratio is 90%. Homes in this area sell for 90%. And you can calculate what the average assessment ratios are in any given market to know how your price is comparing to the benchmark. I also like to look a little bit at absorption rate. So if you have a lot of homes on the market and not many are selling, you could be looking at years and years on the market. So when you have a lot of homes on the market, that means you can have a long time in the market. The absorption rate's really going to be high. On the other hand, if lots of homes are selling, then the absorption rate is really quickly. So you can find things are selling at a more rapid pace. And we can do the same calculation here by looking at how many homes are currently on the market, how many have sold during the last 12 months or 6 months, I like to use a year, and that will equal the absorption rate. Another example here is that if there's 20 properties on the market, 5 have sold in the last year, the absorption rate is 4, meaning there's a 4-year supply of competing offerings on the market today. So if you look at our sales grid, we can do both of these calculations pretty easily. If we look up here, in each case, we have the sales price, the assessment, and then the assessment ratio is calculated automatically. I'm going to X out of here real quick and go to a live spreadsheet so you can see actually what I'm talking about. So in this case, the comparable number one sold for $6 million. It was assessed for $5,580,000, which means it sold for 107% of its assessment. Look at this property. This is a great argument to be able to show to a potential buyer that it was assessed for $3,584,000 and actually sold for $7,450,000. This happens. So when your listing is priced for more than the assessment, you need to find examples like this to show the seller that they're not the only person who's paying double the assessment. And lastly, our last comp was it sold for $7.6 million. It was assessed for $4,871,000, which means it sold for 156% of assessment. If you look further down on the spreadsheet, it automatically calculates the average of the assessment ratios, which is 157%. So that gives you an idea of what the average is in the marketplace, and you can then compare that to what your offering price is to know if you're on the right track or not. So anyway, I hope that's helpful to you in calculating assessment ratios and using benchmarks and also calculating absorption rates, because it's a very important part of the calculation. Don't forget, if you bought my book, you get you get all these spreadsheets that calculate all these things automatically for free. And you also get a consultation certificate that's worth $400 for 20 minutes on the phone with me to answer any of your luxury real estate questions. So keep those questions coming in. Email me, jack@jackcotton.com. And until next time, make it a great week.